Hey, welcome to episode 147 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble.
What?
Today is April 1st, 2014, and even though Ty fracked up another situation and Adama has to help him, how's that work, Yivvits? You know it better than I. I'm Mr. Bubble.
We'll pick him up together.
Battlestar Galactica.
We'll pick him up together.
He's always dropping the pieces.
Oh, Sigh. He's always, so if he wasn't so drunk all the time.
Is that his name? Sigh. Ty. What is it?
Saul Ty. Saul Sorry, Ty. Right. I did say Sigh.
I honestly didn't know. You've OD'd on it lately.
No, yeah. I you got me mixed. It's your fault.
Okay, that's fine.
I just combined Saul Ty.
You know what, though?
Sigh.
We are friends.
We are friends.
We're friends who play Star Wars.
Played.
What?
Played.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Played Star Wars Galaxies. Which is an MMO.
It was an MMO.
Okay, have we talked about that lately, what those are?
It's a massively multiplayer online role-playing game. MMORPG.
Right.
Yeah, it was one of those.
It was one of those.
You pay a monthly fee.
So we got to make this past tense, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I can just keep correcting you, too.
Oh, right.
That works.
Whatever's funnier. That's
whatever you'd like.
Whatever's more funny.
Yeah.
What do I like?
Chicken wings.
Chicken's good.
Chicken is good.
You eating a lot of chicken lately?
No, I've been eating a lot of fish.
Fish, yeah, you mentioned that.
I had tuna.
Tuna.
And salmons.
Okay. From a can.
Cod.
Cod is good.
And blue hake.
How do you spell hake?
H-A-K-E.
Do they just sell it?
I think it's hake.
Is it around here? Around?
The Schwan's man has it.
Oh, okay.
I don't know where he gets it.
You mean like Swan, too? What?
Schwan's.
Oh, the comp.
Not Schwan's.
Yeah. I don't know what that means.
I don't know either.
Yivvits.
Is it German?
We did it. We're doing another one of these. Can you believe that?
It's amazing.
This is, I think, 3 weeks, maybe.
It's a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
People aren't going to know what to do.
I know. I did warn them on Twitter.
They're not going to know what to do.
Hopefully
that they don't just... Their heads don't explode.
I know. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, what do we do
I don't
next?
Know. Was that all there was?
Yeah, we're friends. I think we did. We're just trying to get this the way it used to be, so it's more smooth, right?
Yeah.
So that I think we ripped off an older episode.
It, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We could explain MMO more if you want.
Yeah, I mean, it's what you explain it this time.
Well, it's just those games you play on your computer. I'm not talking like Pong or old Atari stuff.
Minesweeper.
It's kind of like
It's got an M in it.
You're right. It'd be like if you're playing Minesweeper with other people at the same time, but they're not in the same room.
Can you do that?
I don't know. That'd be awesome. Is there a Minesweeper MMO?
Multi-Minesweeper online.
There might be. That'd be awesome.
That's what that stands for, actually.
I never got Minesweeper.
There's people that are just, it's their game.
I know.
They're great at it.
Everybody's got their thing like
I'm
that.
I'm like, there's this, you click in there and then there's numbers and it's math and is there math? There's got to be math involved.
I like that, but I just don't get it.
I don't either.
Oh.
No. Jar Jar, do you like Minesweeper?
I'm glad to see Jar Jar is with us. I don't know if someone's joking, but they said Jar Jar's going to be in the next trilogy. Is that possible?
That can't be. I mean, there's just too much hate of him.
Yeah.
Jar Jar, are you going to be in the next trilogy?
No.
Good.
Not really, no.
I guess he's under contract and you can't say non-disclosures, all that probably. Yeah. But they are starting filming like any day now, I think.
That's crazy to think about.
Yeah, maybe it's May, but that's happening.
Well, we'll have to start picking up news on Harry Knowles' site again.
Seriously, I looked it up the other day. That site's still there.
Is he still alive?
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, I've been concerned about him in the past.
Right.
He's a big guy.
I know. Harry Knowles.
Yeah.
But we sent him cookies. Let's not forget that.
We did. Yep. He ate them. Apparently he ate them.
He said he ate them.
He said
I flipped the table.
We also were going to make a model of a moisture evaporator.
We're in the planning stage.
Yeah.
So.
We're still. I thought Wookiees were good at constructing stuff. Apparently we're not that good.
It's a plan. Solsons are bad at planning.
We can build them. Right. And we need, you know, Bothans. They're good at CAD work.
They would be.
Yeah, I think they are.
Mm.
Yeah, they're like AutoCAD. They're like
DOS-based with a 386
coprocessor
chip.
The old AutoCAD mouse thing with the loop in the middle of, you know.
I can't picture that.
Yeah, it's a digitizer tablet thing.
Okay.
Jar Jar knows what it is.
Some like the whole workstation would cost $20,000.
Oh, yeah.
That kind of thing.
Yeah, now it would cost $10.
Yeah, so I still look at where I live now, and I think a moisture evaporator would be fun. Yeah, well, we have an extra lot.
I mean, you do. That's right.
I know. It'd be really cool to have
your neighbors one. Would be like, "What? What is this?"
Yeah.
I'm not mocking. That's what their accent is. I know.
I mean, that's awesome.
What is this?
I know. Those are good neighbors.
They are good neighbors.
They're the best. Yeah, not the other neighbor though. That the one that we share.
Shh, he can hear us.
Oh, that's right.
He can hear.
Sorry. He also delivers pizzas too. So we gotta be tip him well. Tip him nicely.
Oh, you said the right word.
Yeah. Yoda, do you like pizza, Yoda?
No!
Oh, no, he likes calzones. Good old Yoda. He's always good for a gag.
Because if you don't tip him, I figure the next time he sees our address, you never know.
No.
Oh.
No.
All right. What else? Are we done?
MMORPGs. Have we discussed enough of that?
Yeah, it's just... It was an online game, World of Warcraft. Yeah, it's
and
like
then
those.
You go there and you pay a monthly fee and you play online with other people.
You used to pay a monthly fee.
That's right. Thank you. Now you've got to correct me.
Yeah, right.
Everything's changed.
Yep.
It's all changed. What are the? Let's list all the various MMOs that are out there now.
Oh my god.
Let's not do that actually. No. But most of them are
Club Penguin. It's pretty much Club Penguin.
Club
Penguin and. From that, I think everything else kind of came from that.
Lotro. Yeah, it came from that. Yeah, Candy Lotro. Crush Online.
Oh, Saga.
Saga.
You got to throw the word Saga in there, those God. Dorks.
They tried, you know, they tried to trademark the word Saga.
I know.
Because of another game that's used it called the Banner Saga, which is actually a good game.
Mm-hmm.
I played it. It's really fun. It's like a story game.
It's like where you match three pieces? And
yeah, you match three things. Yeah, it's that whole thing, you know, you match three. And then, like, it's like the mining game in
Free Realms.
Free Realms.
That was fun.
I mean, you better get a lot of playing on that before it's gone.
I know.
I know that you really like that.
I did.
I liked it too, but.
It was snappy.
But those aren't like, that kind of game, like the multiple match thing, I kind of like that. That's like kind of relaxing to me for some mm-hmm. reason. Mm-hmm. But the match three, forget it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's candy. I don't get it.
The Saga part's funny to me. And
Candy Crush Saga.
They have the same engine and just whatever.
You're going to do it for so long, it's going to be a saga.
Uh-huh.
Right. This is the story of MrBubble and his Candy Crush Saga.
Saga's Ribbon something.
Ribbon Saga.
MrBubble Ribbon...
What? MrBubble's Ribbon Quest Saga.
Ribbon Quest. Seriously, because in the emu they don't have him yet. That's my saga.
Oh, the EMU, the Star Wars. Well, so, okay.
Right, now
we're going back. Yeah.
Escape.
Yeah, backspace. Yeah.
Keep going up levels.
Yeah, Control Alt.
I know when you hit the back button and nothing happens. So you're like, ugh.
Yeah, I had to look at my keyboard to say that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's difficult. Yeah. I'd control things.
Okay, MMO, Star Wars Galaxies was or is?
It was.
Made by Sony.
Was, but now there's an unofficial emulated version that you can play for free.
SWG EMU, yes.
Yes, SWG EMU.
We talked about a little more detail. Just you could listen to the previous episode for more info.
Yes, that would be episode 146.
Yes.
Right.
I think so.
146?
Current minus one, yeah.
The current minus one. I like that math. Yeah, that's easy enough to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah, and the emulator is it still lives on. I mean.
Oh, yeah.
We talk about a couple details of it, but.
Welcome, I'm...
Oh. Lando, hi.
Welcome, I'm Lando Calrissian. I'm the administrator of this facility.
Okay. I actually hit the wrong... I'm still readjusting to the sound clips.
Know.
That's not what I wanted. I was
Sorry, am I interrupting anything?
No.
Because that's when we're just talking and randomly comes in.
Sorry, am I interrupting anything?
We're both out of cryo freeze, so just a little... Yeah.
Well, quite literally, in fact.
Yeah,
it's...
Oh my God, let's not get into the weather.
It's been a cold winter up here in Minnesota.
This morning really frustrated me.
Were
that
you sad?
Ice, wasn't that frustrating?
I just turned on the car and let the defroster go for a while, and it was fine.
Ugh. Anyway, okay, so... It's the game that we loved was shut down by Sony, and then the emulator was out there for a long time, and they kind of cloned it. Or you can play it again. It's there.
Yep.
You can make a character in there, walk around the world, and be a dancer.
You just need a copy of the original discs.
Yes. Or someone on Twitter or wherever told us Steam. If you ever download it on Steam.
Oh, you have everything you need.
Yes, that also works.
Interesting.
Yeah. So you don't need CDs. And also, if you have Oh, we did. What's our phone number? We should. We forgot to plug that.
We'll get to it.
Okay.
Okay. We'll get there.
Call us. Send us email. Comments at you.
We're just on a whack today.
Guys. Yeah. Right. I know.
Let's just start over, Mr. Bubble.
Okay. Rewind. Hey.
Hey. Episode one. Oh no, not again.
Okay. Yeah, that'd be horrible.
No, they can email comments at yivvitsandmrbubble.com. Yeah. Our podcast site is swgpodcast.com. Yeah.
Twitter is yam. YAMB. Send us a picture because someone was...
A picture of what?
Yeah, someone in our little... Some of our friends sent us a picture of all the discs they have for Swig that made me think about it. So if you have a big pile of Swig discs out there, send them to our YAM guy. I'd like to see.
I think I had five sets.
We'll retweet those. Oh, yeah, really?
Yeah, that's
because I know we have the big deluxe box still.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, that's your... I have the book from it still. Yep. I look through it every once in a while.
I know, and that's all valid right now, pretty much.
Oh, it's crazy, though.
The emulator's from the olden days. And
you look at like what they went through in that book. It's like there's like environments and just... Yeah, so much, so much good stuff.
It was alive.
Yeah, it was all a lie, too.
No, but it's alive, I mean. That's,
I thought you said it was a lie.
No. It was there. It was a world for a while. I mean, we were all so much younger, and it was just like...
We were
there was
younger,
Star Wars. Mm-hmm.
Less wise.
Mm-hmm. Mm. But it's there now. And we did a party in the emulator. We
did. We tried to do a party.
Yeah.
That's one thing that's going to stink with emulators, that it is... Some of the things that aren't there that we had at the end of the game.
Oh, right.
For, like, doing social events and stuff.
Okay, right.
And, like, the music is not as fun, for me at least, because you can't do the special band commands. And I know they'll look at adding that stuff or whatever. Mm-hmm. And it's the whole point is that you're back in the game. So I don't want to, you know,
but you didn't,
make that
you
any
noticed,
less important. But
you
it's
noticed
like,
some things missing that were...
Yeah. And, I mean, and some of the issues that were in the original that they had later on fixed or improved... are back there, like there's sometimes a lot of lag with chat and stuff, which just existed in the other. Oh, what are you eating, by the way? Are they?
Sorry.
Are they good?
Yeah, they're yours, buddy.
Yes. We used to have sponsors. Episode is sponsored by who, Mr. Bubble?
Blue Diamond Almonds.
Yes.
Makers of bold wasabi and soy sauce.
Wasabi
almonds.
What's up,
Pan? I'm sorry for chewing, but they're just so tasty.
I wanted to share a sponsor. We get money.
Oh yeah,
that's for that.
That's
and,
right.
You know, we need money.
Mm-hmm.
We should start a Kickstarter actually to get money. I don't think there'd be any legal issues with that.
Well, Blue Diamonds. That's Obi-Wan, a good check.
Can we start a Kickstarter? Would you help us?
Yes.
Oh, all right. There you go. They might have a problem with it.
Possibly.
He'd sell your old land speeders. What he'd do?
Yes.
It'll be enough. Obi-Wan is like.
Thank you.
If you watch, Obi-Wan always is selling your crap in the background.
Obi-Wan, selling your crap.
And he's like, what did he get, like 2000 or something?
Yeah, not much. He's an old man then, for one thing. So, I mean,
it'll be enough.
It'll be enough. Yeah. It's like, here's a nickel.
Exactly.
Oh, Luke, it'll be enough. Don't worry.
There had to be high miles on that speeder, too, don't you think?
Yeah.
It was beat up.
It was a piece of crap.
That was a piece of crap. The tranny was about to go out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And her name was...
Oh, I just knew you were going to go
there. Oh, come on.
That's funny.
Yeah, it's just
that's funny.
Bad joke. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Bad jokes have not stopped our podcast.
I name most transmissions. Yes.
Nothing wrong with trannies. You can say tranny, right?
Oh, well, I was talking about transmissions
in
this case. Yeah.
Me too.
Okay. Right,
like
fine.
A torque flight.
Yeah.
Translation to Chrysler.
Yes. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I hope it doesn't take too long.
Oh, he's talking about the show. He's like,
oh, okay, all right,
yeah,
right, right.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, here comes Lando. Lando's walking over again too.
Oops, that was not the right sound effect again. God, I'm just so off.
All right, that's okay. I'm
failing, Mr. Bubble.
Still a cryo freeze.
What am I gonna do?
Your eyesight will return.
Your eyesight.
That's good.
Your eyesight will return.
That's good. That's good.
Yeah.
That's really good.
I always wondered how, like, Yeti, what is it? Yeti, Yato. Yeah. Those three words are, like,
I know.
A lot of text.
It could be a digital language or something. I don't know.
What are they, binars?
Mm-hmm. You may have said.
No.
The binars are I am a binar in my life in a lot of things.
Yeah, I know you are.
I realize that.
Yeah,
you know?
You're like on or off or
right. What is your binar?
You're not a quantum computer.
You may
there's no like state state shifting thing happening.
Yeah, why didn't you tell me? Like, you may have said no.
No, somebody else had to say no every time.
Oh, right.
Yep. No, I swear, you may have
said no.
No. Try one more time.
Oh, okay, let's get this.
You
stuff.
May have
said
no. There you go. That was so.
So
worth
they
it.
Rip off the Enterprise. That's a right. great episode. That is a great episode.
Logically, makes so much sense.
Oh yeah. Let's just rip a hotwire the Enterprise and peel out around the corner.
God, the Tauntaun is really loud.
They're gnawing at something.
I'm sorry, am there I interrupting anything?
Okay, sorry. Yeah, he's here to put us back on schedule.
You look absolutely beautiful.
Thank you, Lando.
You truly belong here with us among the class.
Schmoozer.
He's always got this thing for you. I don't know what it is.
For me.
He's a Solistan. No, he's just like, he's, you know, it's nothing bad.
Well, it's because we both wear capes.
There's nothing dirty about it. It's a cape thing.
Cape, man.
And ribbons. Lando secretly has ribbons that he dangles behind him as he walks around.
When he plays with the cat.
He does. Yeah. He's got a cat dancer.
How about Qui-Gon?
Qui-Gon? He's just got a really big lightsaber.
They're all the same
color
side.
What color is his lightsaber anyway?
Qui-Gon is what? Green? I really don't remember.
I don't remember.
We're so not nerdy on
I think thing. It was like at least like 5 inches bigger than Obi-Wan's.
Oh, come on now.
What?
What, the length of it, or what?
Yeah.
Or the whole, what's that
no, the,
thing
the,
called?
The holes, the, yeah, the holder yeah. part. What do you call okay. that? The,
I don't know.
The grip? The grip. The base.
Not the shaft. What?
I don't know what you call that.
I don't know. I mean, I can't, I know I've seen like pictures on the web of like
the base is
50
the,
times
the
length.
You're talking about the base or the tip?
Lightsabers. We're talking lightsabers and...
I know
the whole,
that.
The whole thing.
Damn, Mr.
The whole
Bubble.
Thing. The whole thing.
Jeez.
The whole thing.
Okay, fine.
What?
What?
Okay, the blade. Is right. the blade always the same?
Yes, probably.
Okay, but that thing they hold.
No, it's not because I think, like, okay. The Sith guys.
Yeah.
So the Darth Maul.
Yeah.
See, that's how much I don't really care for those first movies. It took me that long to figure out Darth Maul's name.
Oh, right. Yep.
But no, he has a double-handed one. That one, I'm pretty sure, looks longer. It's long enough to need two hands, so...
Right.
Right.
But the things that come out, the blades...
It comes
the
apart, too.
Oh, it does?
Yeah.
Purposely, or when he gets cut in half?
Oh, you're right, it doesn't.
I don't know.
You're right. It doesn't come up. It's right, you're right, he cuts it in half. Why is it still working, then, if you cut it in half?
I don't know. There's so we're going to insult everybody, but I mean, come on, the prequels, just, they didn't happen. They just didn't happen.
No, they didn't.
Darth Maul was the first movie, right? He was Menace, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I
I know we're partly kidding about that, but, like, as far as, like, we don't know, but we kind of don't know sometimes.
You can just throw away episode one. Episode one just really doesn't
like,
matter.
Like, anything with episode 4 through 6... We pretty much get a handle on just fine, you know, other than trying to find sound clips.
And
for
we've
it.
Talked about, have we talked about the machete order before? We could talk
the
about
the machete
that.
Order.
Yeah, we talked about that in a few.
Oh
a few
yeah.
Episodes.
Like what about it though?
The way you watch the movies, that kind of thing.
That's order
to watch
order.
This one guy made a really popular order. I even heard it on public radio. They had
really?
This guy on there. Yeah.
The machete order.
It's a way to watch the episodes. We could talk about it in a future episode, well, but it's really
would you watch one through. No.
That'd be one way. But if you don't, if you want, like, you got a picture of somebody who's never watched Star Wars before.
Okay.
And he's tested this on people who haven't seen it.
Okay.
And what you do is you watch 4, 5, 2, 3, 6. Forget about one. You don't need one. And he's confirmed
but
this.
But why
with,
is two? Why are those in the middle like that?
Oh, because it's kind of like a flashback. Like if you watch the whole saga, it's an interesting way to watch it.
It's like it's
and
not
it a, saves a surprise of the. It makes the ending the ending.
Oh, you're right.
And Darth Vader says, "I'm your father," and then you get two stories about the rise of Darth Vader and Obi-Wan hanging out. And Obi-Wan looks like a younger Alec Guinness.
Yeah, you don't need that other one at all.
And you don't.
You just don't need it.
Jar Jar has like one line in there.
It doesn't even matter. Yeah, it's like it's acceptable if it didn't exist before.
Right. I haven't done it, but I'd like to do that with you sometime.
I would enjoy that.
Get some of your so-called friends, and I'd like to meet these friends of yours.
Yeah. Okay. Sexy cakes.
Yeah. God, I love that skit. Look up Sexy Cakes Saturday Night Live.
Patrick Stewart.
God. I'd like to meet these friends
I'd
of yours.
I'd like to meet these friends of yours.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
I'd like to meet these friends of yours.
I've made a few adjustments to your order.
This is the same cake.
No, this one's chocolate. But
SNL skit. Okay, machete. It's probably like taken off of YouTube right away, of course, all the time.
It's not. Yeah, it's not on YouTube, but you can Google it every now and then.
You can buy a Hulu account.
Yeah. But Machete Order. Look that up. Maybe we'll talk about it in the future, but it'd be a fun way.
Was his name Machete? Oh, it's because you're slicing out the episode?
I don't know. I think the guy's site has some machete in the name, but it's easy to Google. Okay. It's got tons of hits.
Interesting.
4, 5, 2, 3, 6.
Okay.
And it just, it makes sense when you read about it. And it'd be cool just to try it sometime. Yeah.
Cool.
Well,
you know, like a year ago, I watched, I watched the Harmy's special edition. Remember, he's the one that
tell me.
He like recut all the movies together, like all different sources.
Okay.
And made like a Blu-ray copy of like episodes, the old ones.
Yeah.
And like did all sorts of things that they forgot to do, apparently, and when they redid the special editions. Like, you know, color correction and bringing out certain color and he took out all the special edition, you know, CGI stuff for most of it. And fix things like if there was bad matting on the lightsabers. Like, why didn't they fix the bad mats? Not lightsabers, on the TIE fighters. Why didn't they fix the bad mats on the TIE fighters in special edition?
I don't know.
All this computer power in the world.
Right.
And they can do anything. They can generate a new character for a stupid new movie.
Uh-huh.
But they can't get rid of the blue box around it. This guy did it with, like, Windows Movie Maker.
Right.
And Adobe Premiere. So, it's just, I don't know how, there must be a reason that they didn't fix that.
Probably. I don't know.
Well, those are shields. But they don't have shields!
No, it's not.
They don't have shields.
Did he say that? You just pulled it out
of your butt. No, I didn't say that. He didn't say that, but I could see him, like, reasoning it in his head.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody's, like, too scared to say, but wait, you know they don't, shut up, don't tell them. Anyway.
Well, these were prototype TIE fighters that did have shields.
These were all like TIE fans.
They're like, okay, you got me. I mean, you can't go up against a guy that imagines all this crap.
Yeah, he imagines crap.
Because he'd say, these were two prototype models that did have shields. I'm like, okay, I guess I can't top that.
Well, the first five TIE fighters they always sent in always had shields. But the rest didn't.
I love TIE fighters. I miss them so much. You miss the dance stuff. I know everybody misses space in the emulator, but I miss it so much. And
it was a well done space.
Mm-hmm. And it'll be there.
And it wasn't just the combat part of it. It was like the whole you know, the whole build out, and it was your ship.
Look,
and
I would just fly around and look at stuff, man.
You know what we never did get?
What?
I don't want to make our show's not going to be like all just lamenting about Star Wars Galaxies.
Why not? People love it.
I mean, it could be, but it would just be like sad for us, I think. Because I've pretty much let it go.
Dude,
now.
I think
I've let it go, you know?
It got sad for us when I said episode 147.
It got sad when we started talking about Qui-Gon's lightsaber. Which we all know is the biggest one in Hollywood. So, anyway.
What? Yeah. Was,
I mean, I don't know what you're talking about.
Whatever. Okay.
Whatever.
Continue.
Fine. I think we got an episode title. Yes. Anyway.
You're talking about space?
Oh, yeah, space. Okay, so it was, I don't know what I was saying. It just that, you know what? Okay, things. Oh, I know what it was. Sorry for all this yammering, folks.
It's just like old times here.
It's just like old times, except we're not editing this stuff out as much.
I know.
You got to listen to it now.
You're
stuck. Gonna listen to it.
Mm-hmm.
Saul.
I really fracked it up, Bill.
That's
a lot of
pieces. And we'll put them back together.
A lot of pieces to pick up.
And we'll put them back together.
We'll pick them up together. That's a great...
It's a great series. Okay. Let me finish that for the space thing first.
Mm-hmm.
Things we didn't get, which were sad, was we never got docking in space.
Right.
Like, to be able to dock and go to somebody's yacht for a party.
I know, yeah.
We never got to use the yacht like we should have.
Agreed.
And in the old days, it would have been great because you could have, like, 20-person group,
mm-hmm.
but that only existed with the yacht for a very short amount of time.
Mm-hmm. And you couldn't leave. What was the stipulation?
Well,
you could not leave the planet, right?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, warping. Like, yeah.
Yeah, once you left that, you couldn't pick up more people, I think.
Once you land, everybody lands.
Yeah.
Once a pilot lands, everybody lands.
I know. They were so close.
You could go between, like, zones and stuff, but...
Right, but then you couldn't pick up anybody else.
Right, because anytime you land...
Everybody gets dumped.
Yeah, everybody gets dumped out in the thing.
So close.
And I would have been great, but... And that ship... Should have been like, and they should have made it so that could be your house even.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I even had like a great post. I mean, not just me, other people had posts about like you. How you shut up. You know what I meant? I was trying to make it not sound so, you know, like,
I have an idea.
So cocky, you know.
I have an idea.
Say, I have an idea.
Old chap.
Say now.
Have you ever thought about I think we should have 2 starports in every town.
Yes.
What do you think about that?
Possibly.
Yeah, Obi-Wan likes the idea. Obi-Wan loves it.
One on the north side, one on the south side.
Another happy landing.
Well, if you have 2 ports, it's easier to land.
Right.
Exactly.
You might be closer to one, but...
He's right.
Anyway.
Anyway. Okay, so back to... Okay, well, you finish your thing.
Well, what's my thing?
I don't know.
Okay, you finish your thing.
I'm done with my thing. It's just like things that we didn't get that would have been great.
Oh, right. Yeah, right.
And we're not going to get... I mean, because it's... The game's gone. And even though the EMU's there... They just still need somebody to, like, leak them a copy of the server code.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like some good Samaritan, like Smedley, you know?
Yeah, really.
I mean, it's God. Not the code, but, like, just enough to get things going.
They need to
grease the wheels.
They need to send a Dropbox link to SwigSource.
I realize, like, what I'm saying is completely illegal. Like, he could never do that. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I mean, if Snowden can release all that information and just go to Russia.
Dude,
Smedley could go to Russia.
No. There's your answer. Just have Snowden release it. That'd make headlines like you haven't.
Maybe he's a listener.
Snowden.
Oh, wait,
please.
We don't want to get on that radar.
Please, Snowden, release the source for everything. Swigsource.zip.
I think we don't want to get involved with that aspect of the whole thing, like him and stuff. So I would rather actually have Smedley release it, and then he could go to Russia.
Okay.
I mean, that's safer for everybody, really.
Okay.
I mean, not for him, maybe, but he's going to play.
I'm game with that.
He's going to play World of Tanks anyway. So.
As long as you could, as long as you could get some, just live servers that were like the olden days. That'd be nice. And they keep saying whatever you ask for, they say it's going to be there eventually, which is great, but it might be years.
Right, because it's like they're just a small team, and I mean they're doing what they can, but and there are other there's other.
I want a Noompa Loompa.
I want a golden goose. A golden egg. Whatever. Things.
Daddy?
Anyway, so what have I been doing lately?
Yeah, really?
I've been watching Battlestar Galactica again.
I guess.
I haven't watched it for a long time, and now I'm watching it marathoning through the last couple of weeks now.
What a good show.
It's a really good show, and more people should watch it.
Agreed.
I think they should. And it's 4 seasons. It's not like it's ridiculous amount of show to watch.
Mm-hmm.
You're not, like, trying to watch all original episodes of, I don't know, All in the Family or something. Mm. Maybe that didn't last long. What's the show that's gone along? Simpsons. You're not trying to watch every episode of The Simpsons.
Yeah, right. They're,
you know, 50 years or whatever it is. Right. So, if you haven't seen it, you should probably see it.
Well, and it actually is a 4-season story. I mean, it's one of those arcs.
Like, every episode has to do with the story.
Like, Simpsons is just Simpsons. You could scramble the episodes and probably be fine. But
it is? I mean, I thought that the story arc with Marge is just starting to...
I don't know. Maybe it is. I don't know. I know people come and go on that show, but you know what I'm saying, basically.
I know exactly what you're saying.
Uh-huh.
But, like, even Star Trek didn't have an overriding story. They had story arcs now and then, and like a theme maybe, like a season, like this is the Romulan season.
Oh, right.
This is the Cardassian War season.
Here are your bad guys, here are your real bad guys, here are the mystery
guys. This is the Bajoran season, which I Bajorans are just whiny little,
oh my God,
my nose here.
Necklaces.
It's got little nose ring ear
thing. Right.
Yeah.
Bajor.
They should have just annexed Bajor and... Let the Kardashians take them and whatever. That's probably really mean of me. There's probably
I saw everything.
I saw everything.
I saw everything. Yeah. Well, he said it a couple everything. Times. He's like, just matter of fact.
I saw everything.
And at one time
this is another Patrick Stewart clip.
At one time he has Ricky Gervais finish it and he's like, and you saw everything.
is that from Extras?
Yes.
Ricky Gervais.
Yeah. And you saw everything. Yes. Okay.
I saw everything.
That's good stuff.
Oh, so anyway, Battlestar Galactica, it's great. BSG. Yep. Yeah. Who's your favorite character from BSG?
Oh, God.
I love them all, but I mean...
Oh, I like the Cylons. I guess Baltar, to me, is the most interesting.
He is very interesting. He plays a lot of different roles.
Yes.
Like, he goes from being little wimpy scientist guy who...
Right.
You know, I shouldn't spoil anything in case you haven't seen it.
Oh, no. But, Or I guess the Adama, when it comes down to acting chops and everything, it's just every scene he's on is just like tremendous. So.
Yeah. Rosalind, I'm not that big of a fan of.
No.
I mean, she, you need her, and she did a great job, but like just, she's just so conniving.
Yeah.
Like, and she puts on this great front, like she's just, you know, the fleet, the people, blah, blah, blah.
Anyway. Billy. Billy's my favorite character.
Billy?
Yeah. It's like from season one, yeah.
Yeah. He's like he's a couple episodes in season two.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
Oh, poor Billy.
Yeah.
His little, her little aide. Billy.
What a wonderful show, though. I'll try to watch more.
Excellent. Yeah. And the thing that's great, too, is like the whole thing with their theory about, like, they tried to make the science fiction portion of it, like, explainable in that, like, there's no transporters, there's no replicators, there's no, you know, quantum torpedoes, there's nukes, there's nukes, but and there's faster than light travel, but it's not like they can travel you know, constantly. They gotta punch a hole.
They gotta
spin up the FTL.
It's really the way it should be, I think. I mean that's,
but, and the, you know, the great things, like, with, you know, all the space stuff is very muffled because there's not really supposed to be sound. They probably add sound just to make it interesting, but
But every time it cuts to, like, a view of someone who got ejected or something, is silent. You know, so it is silent. Yeah, right.
Yeah,
that's cool.
And the music's great. I've been listening to the soundtrack a lot.
Yep.
So it's awesome.
And religion over time. Just, it's fun. Everything about it's fun. Really.
Yeah. Oh, just, it's a roller coaster.
And the ending is a great ending too. I love the ending.
It was, there was a part of it. Part of me that was like, really? And then I had to think about it, and it was, like, perfect. Yep. So, I mean, at first, my gut reaction was, like, I wasn't sure, but then after I watched it again, I really liked it.
That's funny, because I read some books on human development after that, like, you know, Homo sapien, all that stuff. And it was just interesting after having seen that, just to see, because they had that plugged in pretty well with the years of... I mean, I don't care about spoilers because that show's been out forever.
If you haven't watched it by now, spoiler alert.
But it plugs right into, like, some human development stuff that's, I mean, they spend a little time. It's just fun. It's just, what a great show.
Well, I mean, dude, we're right about now. Should be making Cylons pretty soon.
Yeah.
You know?
Exactly.
Cylons.
Yeah. Okay. So, can we do some name dropping from our party?
Oh, let's do that, Mr. Bubble.
Yeah, just quick, some people, because
we had a little in-game
event. Mentioned we had a party, and we went into Swig Emo, so just follow our Twitter feed. We're kind of spur of the moment with that stuff, but if you follow that, we'll try to tell you when. But we met some new friends. There's Zago, Z-A-G-O.
Zago Ipa.
Is that what it is?
Yep.
Oh, excellent. Good.
He is a Bothan? Was he? Is he Rodan?
I apologize, Zago.
We don't remember your race. I'm sorry.
No. Otio?
For your species.
Remember Otio?
Otio, yeah. He was there.
Otio.
Otio.
Tricentius. I don't know why he didn't do Bicentius.
That was Bicentius. He may have had an issue.
Yeah. So he's Tricentius.
Yep.
L-Y-S-H-I-K. Lishik.
Lishik, sure.
I don't remember. I'm sorry.
That Lishik. Works. We didn't have a ton of people there.
Shucky. I just did some name. Then someone on the Swig staff, or Swig Emo staff, helped me. I was just a bonehead with my password and stuff.
That was great.
But that's Niffer. If you're out there, Niffer, thank you. That was very helpful. They actually have good support. I mean, it was a Saturday. It's a free game. I clicked the chat session. A guy got in there, whoever, and helped me with my password issue.
Yeah.
And I mean, that was not bad
and
for free.
And their password thing is convoluted and stupid. Because it, like, uses your forms password to get into the game, and there's, like, this sync thing that doesn't happen all the time, and there's a delay. They gotta improve on that. I don't know why they're using their forms as their security, but whatever.
True.
PHP BB is actually really insecure these days. It's, like, not that great, but they're obviously using it. At least you don't have to put your credit card in it.
Right. Yeah, right. What was I going to say?
Well, we had other people there, too.
What else you got?
Hubcap was there.
Hubcap, yep.
Mumat showed up.
That's right.
Mumata. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of people, but it was short notice, and we were glad to see people, though.
Absolutely. And we'll do more. We'll just hop in there once in a while.
Yeah, just go in there, hang out at a hotel, or it's like Coronet.
Mm-hmm.
People just... talking to
us. Yeah, what do? We started in Theed.
In Theed.
Like, you go out
the starport. Yeah.
Yeah, you take a left, and there's, like, the microphone in the middle of the plaza, and then we were there for a while.
The microphone, which you can turn on.
Yeah.
But it doesn't do anything.
It's exactly as intended, yeah.
Intended. Then working as intended.
After that, yeah, and that's just the way we do our party. So, like, we get bored and we just know when it's time to move on, yeah. Right? And then we move to Coronet.
Yep. And then we got bored and we left. Well, but by the while we're talking about Zago, he sent us an email. He says,
all right.
He's got a quick question he hoped we could answer. Can you settle the question of what Wookiee ribs really are? Are they ribs cooked in the style of the Wookiee people, or is it the ribs of a Wookiee? And it is Wookiee style ribs.
Agreed. Seasoning. It's like,
yes.
Yeah, like that part of the world.
I mean, the other is just, it's just disgusting. I mean, yeah. I don't say I'm going to go and eat human ribs.
Right.
You know, it's that. This is gross.
No, not sentient. It's not cool to eat sentient creatures' ribs. Sentient creatures.
It's not cool at all. So there you go, Zago.
Beef ribs. Oh, yeah.
They're not sentient yet.
Not in this.
Well, I hope it doesn't take too long.
Yeah, the ribs will be ready soon.
All right, that's a quick, easy answer. Yeah, what else?
Oh,
this is
let's
email.
See.
Comments at YivvitsAndMrBubble.com.
Yes. Shean of Flurry. Shean of Flurry.
Fly Rye.
Says, thanks for all the podcasts. Keep up the good work. Thank you very much. And he or she corrected us on, I guess it's a he.
99% chance it's a he.
No, well, yeah, because the person's name is in here, so I'm
no,
guessing
because
that's
it's, we're talking about
I'm
swing.
Guessing, but I have seen women named that too, so I okay, don't
it
know.
Could be.
I don't know. I don't know. What? What?
Are you brain dead?
No, there are two of them. Stupid.
In the ventilation shaft.
They got the ventilation shaft.
That one is like, what is that person? Why are they wearing like bug eyes and stuff?
I've been watching the Clone Wars cartoons, and he's in a couple episodes of season one, and it bugs me
really
there.
Really expands his character, doesn't
oh,
it?
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah. Well, this person asks us. Shanna Flurry says, or they want to let us know. We talked about like Smedley talking about, he's talking about the thing we discussed where Smed posted something about a new game for SWG players.
Oh, right, right, right.
And we didn't mention this, but we knew it at the time. But it's good that he reminded us that Smed already had said it's not SWG or it's not like a Star Wars related game.
Okay.
And then he also had another post later on his Twitter that says, the only update is I won't shoot my mouth off anymore about how SWG fans will like it. Sorry I did that. My mistake.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's such a rabid crowd.
But, I mean, I get what he was saying. I mean, I didn't take it as, like, oh my god, it's going to be Star Wars Galaxies 2. But everybody, you know, there's so many people. They're like, oh, yeah, that's got to be it. So, I don't know. But thanks for pointing that out. He also mentioned that there's other EMU, which we know. It's SWG or Project SWG. I think you maybe mentioned it.
Yeah.
And this one is closer to what the game was after the NGE, before it was shut down. And it's not as far along as SWG EMU, but there's a lot of cool different things in this version, I guess. So, there you
okay.
go.
Did he mention any of those cool things? We could research that. Maybe we could try it out. Yeah.
Because it's post-NGE, closer to after the game.
Yeah.
That's what the version they're going for.
Right.
Yep. Yeah.
Because there's one called Tarkin, I think, some variant. I don't think
that's
right.
There's Tarkin. And that one, like, you can have, like, housing in player cities.
Yeah, right.
In non-player cities.
Yeah. Yes, right. In the big towns. Yeah. And I almost got in there. I mean, I got an account set up maybe, but I just... My personal reason was, like, in our case,
you
couldn't have a lot of people on at the same time. They had a cap.
Oh, okay.
Like 100 people simultaneously. At the time, it was like 100 simultaneous users or something like that.
So it's pretty small.
Yeah, and that's even the Swig Emu is thousands right now.
Yeah.
It like tells you all the time.
2,000, 3,000?
I think so. 3,000 max, and it's usually 2K or in
there. 2K?
I think so. Yeah.
Check it out, though.
Mm-hmm.
One other one here from Mr. Frackman.
Frack.
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 Bill, I really fracked this up again.
Don't worry. We'll pick up the pieces together. Saul.
Who said anything about pieces, Bill?
Saul, get your act together.
Bill, I dropped my bag of Reese's Pieces all over the floor.
Don't worry. We'll pick them up together.
Not bad.
One,
two, three. This one's for you.
Wow, the old man loves his Reese's Pieces. I don't do a very good tie.
The old man.
The old man. Oh, old man. Good luck throwing out an air vent. Or an air vent. Airlock. Goodness me. Goodness me. Okay. Frackman asked us if we've heard about Twitch and thought that maybe we should do a live streaming event on Twitch TV. And I'm going to just say, that's a great idea, but I don't want to play a game and record it and then you can watch it.
Yeah.
Because, not because you wouldn't maybe enjoy it, but because I think it's stupid. Yeah. Like, I don't get it. And I don't mean that to offense to Frackman at all. Because I know we've talked to Frackman before. Mm-hmm. He's a great guy. And I appreciate all ideas. But I just don't get live streaming your game session. Like, I don't get it. Do you?
No, the only time I do that is like when I'm on YouTube looking up how to beat a Mario level or something.
Right. You know? Well, I mean, I know you were always on Omogul all the time.
What's that? That's...
Or it's one of those, it's like a dirty sex chat.
Oh,
thing.
Right.
Yeah. I don't know how I know about that.
Yeah, really. Seriously. It's like, and here's a URL.
I don't know what. Okay. I stepped into that one.
That's all right.
I stepped into that one.
Yeah.
I'm not on there. At least not as Yivvits.
But, right.
I heard Liam Neeson's on there, though. I mean, Qui-Gon. Anyway, so no, I just don't get it, and it's great. People might like it, but I don't understand, like, the entertainment value of watching another person play and, like, now here's what I'm going to do in this level. Oh, man, they just shot me. Oh.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm going to power up and buff now. I don't get it.
It doesn't seem to fit our gameplay.
It must be an age thing or something, or just I'm not cool enough.
I wouldn't want people to see my chat window. I like talk smack about people in the chat window.
You're terrible.
Well.
Just all the things.
You and I used to be in voice chat when we'd play the game sometimes.
We did?
Yeah, at parties once in a while.
Oh, yeah, because we'd be like, oh, gotta help so-and-so. Can you go pick up Obi-Wan at the Starport? He doesn't have enough credits.
Those are the days, man. That was so funny, yeah.
Oh, you're so green. Obi-Van
Kenobi. I just saw him in the game, too.
Good guy.
He was in, I logged in about a week ago, and I saw him, he was R-Y apostrophe. But he's also known as Obi-Van Kenobi from the past.
Obi-Van
Kenobi. I vaguely remember Rye from the olden days.
I think so. I mean, that was like an alternate name or something.
Shadowfire. Yeah. And the
Rye, like a rye bread, a nice rye bread. I like rye bread.
Obi-Van Kenobi, he called in, I think, a couple times
Obi-Van
in the day.
Obi-Van Kenobi. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, I agree.
Trivia.
Yep. Trivia time.
All right, anyway, but yeah, so we had voice chat. We would talk smack about people. Be like, oh, this guy's so annoying, or you know, whatever.
Said that.
Okay, I did. And you're always like, John, you're.
I mean,
Mr.
it
Bubble.
Was all in jest,
of course.
Mostly.
Yep. Yeah. So party. That was
yeah.
And it got the kinks out. That was the main thing. Like, I brought my machine over to your house, and had the login.
Just
gotta
remember your password and your account now. That's all we gotta get you to do.
I've logged in a couple times. We'll
write it down for you.
I know. And the guy, it was a Niffer.
Niffer.
N-I-F-F-E-R.
It could be a woman. We don't know.
Could be. 99% chance it's not. But
Niffet.
It could be.
Maybe.
But I accidentally.
There was a girl that played Star Wars Galaxies.
There were a couple, yeah. But Niffer kind of spanked me a little bit and said, you know, you're not supposed to have two accounts.
You didn't know.
Well, yeah.
It was an accident.
He goes, I'll have to delete that account for you. I'm like, okay, that's fine.
Whatever.
Like, don't delete Mr. Bubble.
Yeah, there was some concern there for a little while. Like, where did Mr. Bubble's account go?
I know. It's like,
his character's missing.
God, I was so mad. But it's good. That's part of the background thing of the party. It's just to work the kinks out and just to do it.
Yeah.
We did it, so we're ready at the drop of a hat.
I like it. Okay. We'll do it again.
Mm-hmm.
We'll do it again.
We'll do it live.
Do it live. I'm going to slice this.
The Winnie Mini.
The Winnie Mini. Innovation.
Design.
Do you believe any of that?
I saw everything.
Hey, you know what? I got something for us.
What?
I have a treat. You remember when we used to do the mystery beverage?
That was a long time ago, but yes, that was like whatever came out of the brown paper bag we had to drink.
Yes.
And it wasn't like alcoholic or something stupid like that.
No, I mean, it could have been.
Remember
but
that
it
podcast?
Wasn't.
They would just get drunk on the air. That's so stupid.
I don't
if you
get
ask
it.
Me.
I just, okay, great. You're
that
drunk.
That was their bit.
Ah, you're funny.
That's such a young man's sport.
You're so funny. I'm so funny. I'm drunk on the air.
Exactly. But ours is funny. If it bends, it's funny.
If it bends, it's funny?
If it breaks, it's not funny.
Okay, I'm not sure where that's from, but that's fine. That's fine.
If it bends...
Qui-Gon quote or something. let me go and get the drinks, okay?
Yeah, this is Hold great. On. We're okay. going to pause it?
Yeah. Okay, I'm back now from the kitchen. Mr. Rubble.
This is exciting. We drink whatever comes out of this brown bag.
So this is appropriate because I'm going to an anime convention
this
weekend.
And you swear you're not dressed in anything, just for the record.
I am not dressing in anything.
Okay.
I mean, that's my costume. I'm not dressing in anything.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is a Japanese soda.
Okay.
Called Ramune.
Ramune.
Ramune. I just had to look up the pronunciation again to be sure. It's very fun. It's good. It's sugary. And it's fun because it's got like a little marble thing in it that closes it. See? that's how it closes.
Yeah. How's that work?
I'll let you do one. Okay. But there's three flavors. Okay. These are flavors that you don't normally buy. You don't normally buy these. Okay. So the first one we're going to try.
And I don't have to drink the whole thing, but I'll take a good swig. Yeah.
Don't believe me. I'm not drinking the whole thing either.
Okay. But I'll take a healthy swig.
Should I have a glass for you so we could, you know, because I don't like to share, you know?
Yeah, a little.
I'm kind of like that. Understood. I'm Wookiees, you know?
Pause it again. Let's get a glass.
Well, you know what? I'll drink first.
Fine.
And then I'll let you drink because you don't care as much.
I don't care as much.
Celestins have like an antibacterial
solution. Yeah, it's like cats.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll let you open it, though. Okay, this one is.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. This one is teriyaki flavor.
Oh my goodness, really?
Yes.
I do like teriyaki, but good lord.
So you just put the thing down and you push the little marble in with the plunger.
Just straight down?
Yep. Hard. Here you go. Push it in. There you go. Oh, there you got it.
Wow.
Yeah. So now it's in there.
Yeah.
And see, there's like a little... It sits in this cute little thing here in the middle of the marble.
I smell teriyaki sauce. How horrible is that?
Mm.
Okay. Okay, here goes Yivvits. Mm. He's drinking. What is it called? Like, teriyaki?
I've had it before.
Teriyaki what?
Teriyaki flavor.
Okay, teriyaki flavor beverage. Ugh. Mm. Big. He took a big swig there.
This one's not bad.
Okay.
I would say it actually tastes a lot like maple syrup.
Okay. This is made by Kikkoman Company, or however you say that, right?
Kikkome?
Yeah.
Maybe? I don't know.
Okay, here comes.
Kikkome.
Eh.
Here goes Mr.
How bad? If
teriyaki.
If your face didn't grimace or anything, so...
I'm saving that one. All right. This one I could actually drink. This one's not terrible. Oh, Mr. Bubble does not agree.
It's just different. I mean, It's not horrible like some of those leafy, grassy things we drank in the past. Remember that?
Those were bad. We have bread here, by the way.
Did you bake this bread?
I did. It's par-baked.
Yeah, that's great. So you... baked?
They bake it partly, and then you finish it. Yeah. It's like a take and bake, you know, Papa John's.
Right.
Okay. So we have bread to clear our palates, and also so we don't vomit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you have to listen to us chew.
Yum, 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 yum.
I'm glad I'm getting rid of these because I'm never going to drink these otherwise.
Yum, yum, yum. Okay.
Okay, so I'm going from not terrible to other.
Oh my god, really?
Because I've had these before.
Okay.
Do
you have one that you've not had yet?
No, but I don't remember this one.
Okay.
This one is takoyaki. Takoyaki.
Okay.
Which I think, if I remember from the website, is like rice balls or something with octopus in them or something.
Really? Honestly?
Something like that. Takoyaki. Or I have that completely wrong.
Okay.
So I'm going to open this one up.
They're also sugary?
Oh, yeah. It's all sugary.
Sugary octopus?
Yeah.
What is the Japanese and the octopus and the tentacle thing, man? Nice. That packaging is the fun, isn't it?
It's very fun. And the other flavors are great. I mean, they're really sweet, but they're refreshing.
Fruity.
And
uh-huh.
Yeah. So, you know, this is just a bad example, really.
No,
of this,
that's the point, though.
Of Ramune.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so here we go.
All right. Octopus.
Smells like toilet bowl cleaner.
Ugh. I think I'd rather drink that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude. The Wookiee's grimacing.
I don't think you're going to like that.
Oh, no.
Okay. The smell?
Yeah.
It's very gingery.
Okay.
It's gingery. And the smell and the taste right away is overpowering, but then it's not as bad.
Okay.
Like, you could... If you had to drink this No, if you had to drink it, I wouldn't. I mean, I still wouldn't do it.
Oh, my God. Okay, I'm going to take a smell first, and we'll see.
Okay, he's going to smell it. Hang on. Yep.
Oh, that is so odd. It's just so interesting. We just don't have that flavor.
Ugh. Well, and these are, like, specialty ones. I don't think, like, I don't necessarily think people just drink these every day over there, but...
You know, that kind of, ugh, no. Well, initially, Hell no.
You better have some bread.
I will. But initially, it reminded me of those root beer candy things. Just, I got a little bit of
root beer barrels?
Yeah, yeah, those little guys. But that went away really fast.
Certainly isn't root beer barrels.
It's maybe the opposite of that.
I'm gonna have some Diet Pepsi Max, too.
That's my... You know, in some in Japan right now, there's another podcast. They're, like, pulling out... Pepsi Max.
Diet right Pepsi and Muxel.
Oh, it's horrible.
Watashiwa.
Yeah.
I just said I am, basically, I think.
You.
But... Okay, now this one.
Okay.
This is where I'm not sure I can actually drink this one.
Really? I like this. What is it?
Because I
have you done this one before?
It's Kimchi. Okay. Kimchi flavored. And I don't know. Like, There's like a happy little bowl on the label. Of course, it's smiling.
Oh, like kimchi or whatever that is. Kimchi.
Not kimchi. Okay. Not kimchi. I don't think it's kimchi.
Okay.
This is kimchi. All
right.
But I could be wrong. Maybe it's kimchi. All I don't know. I got to shake it a little bit. Because there's a lot of sugar. You got to get mixed up.
Okay.
All right. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Again, that's the most interesting part.
Oh, just the smell of this one alone. I'll do it because you're doing it, but I really don't like it.
Well, it's no fun if we don't like them.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Yeah.
It smells like a bad scratch and sniff sticker.
Oh, I hate those in the book.
One that's made to be like pizza. Mm-hmm. Oddly, like pizza. How is this pizza? I don't know how it's pizza.
They say it's pizza.
They say it's pizza, but it's not. It's like chemicals and...
All right. Well, what is it? This is... Okay, just let's jump in. It's red... Yivvits doesn't like the smell. He's now, his face is really grimace. Oh, look at him.
Oh, God.
Oh, no. Mm. Yivvits. You poor guy.
Oh. Oh, my God.
Oh. Is it like cough syrup or even worse?
No, I just can't explain it. It's just so bad.
Okay.
Oh.
Look at you. Any Pepsi Max left? Bread. Fresh baked bread. All right. I'm going to take a smell here. Let's see.
I might die.
Is the smell bad, too, you say?
No.
Oh, that is not right. What is that?
It's foul.
Oh.
Are you going to throw up?
No. If I do, I'll over your keyboard. You know?
Okay. It'll just
that
taste
is
like...
That is wrong.
It's rancid.
Are you sure it's not spoiled? Is there a
No, date I know it's not spoiled. I mean, it's basically sugar water.
All right, let's get it over with. It's like, again, it's like the scene in Gladiator. You don't know what's coming out the door. But if we all unite together.
Mmm. Did a big old swig.
That is just not right. Oh. Dude, it doesn't get any better either. It gets worse.
It gets worse.
Oh.
You better drink it to eat something else. I mean.
Oh, I'm just trying to explain that. No, that's just not proper.
We should probably look out what that is.
Oh.
It's going to be something very disgusting, I have a feeling.
Maybe more than tentacles.
Kimchi. What is kimchi?
Toxic waste.
Looks terrible. it's not kimchi.
Okay.
What is the difference between kimchi and kimchi? It is blah blah blah. Huge business in Japan. It's considered hot. Korean? No, I don't know. This is one of those stupid forums where everybody's like, here's what I think it is. It's the way Japanese pronounce kimchi? I don't know. In any case, it's terrible.
Yeah, that's what it means.
It's just terrible. It's often described as spicy or sour. Well, it's a little bit of both of those. I don't really...
I've eaten bread.
Oh, here's what it is.
What?
It's made from spicy fermented cabbage.
Of course. What could be better than that?
It tastes great, somebody says here.
Well, that's basically kimchi, right? That's cabbage and all sorts of...
Yeah.
Really big in North Korea, if you must know, so...
Yeah. So it's perfect to accompany many Japanese recipes, such as yakiniku.
Hmm.
It's originally Korean, yes, so, okay. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, it's this... That one takes...
I hate kimchi. My wife loves kimchi. She makes it at home.
What?
She sits on the couch and eats it.
Will you do me a favor? Take that to her?
Sure.
And see what she thinks of it.
Honestly, I will. Yep.
I want to know. You got to text me and tell me.
Absolutely.
I need to know. You want to take all three, you can.
No. I don't want them in my house.
The cat might even die if you...
I do have to clean the drain out. It'd probably burn right through the drain.
I think for that one, you probably want the takoyaki.
Ugh.
I'll find out what that one is later, too. I mean, they look really delicious, right? They look like donuts.
Oh, and everybody's happy
in
the
bottle.
They got sprinkles. Look how happy they are.
They got sprinkles.
They're happy because they sold it to you. And it's out of their inventory.
Yeah. Well, there's one more that I don't have because we drank it at another event a little party. Mm-hmm. It was chili oil.
Yeah.
And it wasn't actually hot or anything. It was actually pretty good. You could drink it, but I think I'll stick to the lemon or the white grape and those.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
the bread, very
well
good
done.
To have.
Well done. That was fun. We haven't done that in a while.
And I'll have some more things from the anime convention I'm going to, because they have lots of Japanese food and things like that. And candy.
I think I know where I'm going to get the next. I'm going to do the beverage thing next time.
Okay, yeah.
And they have to be things that are FDA certified that you can drink, right?
You can't serve me raw milk.
No, but something I could buy at a store, right? Yeah. Valid?
Yes.
Something I buy in the medical aisle? Valid? Or
what?
No? Yes or no? There are plenty of drinkable things there. That are made to be drunk.
Like, I'm not going to drink, like, milk of magnesia.
No, nothing like that.
Or aloe vera.
No, something that's made to be drunk. I'll find. I'm trying to think of a category. If you have any tips on what we should drink next.
You can drink hydrogen peroxide, but I wouldn't recommend it.
Yeah, they used to in all sorts of. People used to eat Vaseline.
Well, you can.
I know.
I mean, if you're plugged up, I guess you eat some Vaseline.
Yeah, they just do that for medical stuff.
Delicious.
Anyway. Mm-hmm. Anyway, awesome, Yivvits. Good job.
I'd rather eat the Vaseline than the kimchi or kimchi.
Kimchi, liquid kimchi. Perfect.
Well, I'm glad you liked it. I'm glad you didn't like it, I guess.
Yeah.
You know, this one, I drank more of it the first time.
Yeah.
And I think this time I hated it more because I knew what I was expecting.
Oh, gotcha, right.
And for like 2 weeks afterwards, I couldn't eat soy sauce because it reminded me of that.
Yeah.
Like gagging from it. Now I've ruined it again.
Uh-huh.
I can't eat soy sauce again.
All right, what do we got?
That's all I got right now.
That's it? Okay.
We had some voicemails. We can do them next time.
Yeah, let's bank them up.
Because, we're trying to do these more now, so...
Yeah, right.
We got to save things. I know we had an email from, or a voicemail from Ithorian.
Yeah.
Because we forgot his name when we mentioned people.
I know, yeah.
And we felt terrible about that. So, sorry, Ith. And I don't know who else we forgot, but I'm sure there's lots of people.
Yep.
Anyway... So what are you going to do this week? You going to go and play some emu?
Yeah, I'm going to hop in there occasionally. I got after the party, I got a little desire to level up my musician part because I'm not a master entertainer.
Oh, right.
I'm a master dancer, which I think I mentioned this last show.
Of course you're a master dancer.
I am. I leveled that up in no time at all. And then I'm like, great, I'm done. I can do all the dances. Oh, no, you can't do formal too.
Oh, I agree.
They give you formal too when you're master entertainer.
I see.
That's when you get it?
I think so.
Hmm.
Is that the term, master entertainer or master?
Yeah, master. Yep.
That one, because when you do music and...
It's like the pinnacle of everything.
It's what everybody's going for.
Really?
No.
No?
People still want to be Jedi.
Really?
Yeah.
That doesn't surprise me. Obi-Wan's a Jedi.
Yes.
he wanted to be a Jedi.
Possibly.
How about you? You're going to the convention.
Anime convention.
Okay, that'd be fun.
Gonna hang out there and geek out and look at people and...
Nothing wrong with that.
It's actually really fun. I mean, I like some anime, but I'm not dressing up, despite what you think I am.
This is a fine outlet to admit that.
Right. Okay. I'm dressing up as Obi-Wan. Yeah. Dressing up as Qui-Gon's lightsaber.
That'd be fine.
Yeah. But that wouldn't be fine, as a matter of fact. But anyway. So that'll be lots of fun. And next time you're going to have a drink for us, apparently, that I'm going to
die from. I'll see if I can find something.
Die from it. Gonna like feed me like
something homeo
epicac.
Something homeo. Oh, that'd be horrible. No, something homeopathic maybe. There must be some herbal.
Well, we do
things.
Have a, we have a health food store in town. I bet they've got some weird crap.
Yeah, some that just tastes off, but Like, it's harmless.
Here's a bunch of flaxseed oil.
Yeah, something like that. Right, right, yeah. Right.
It's good omega-3 something.
Yeah, I could just give a nice strong prune juice or something. I don't know.
Warflight prune juice.
I know. Warrior's drink.
It's just warrior's
Remember
drink.
That? The first time he drinks it, he's like, warrior's drink.
Warrior's
drink. Doesn't Whoopi Goldberg give it to him?
Yes. Yeah, I don't know. Does it imply he's constipated? I don't know.
I don't know.
Do Klingons get constipated?
I don't know.
I don't know either. But maybe next time we'll find out on our show.
To call up a Klingon plumber, see if they have a lot of
Klingon plumber.
Service calls.
Yeah. Maybe Klingon proctologist.
That too.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe they're the same thing in Klingon.
Warrior's drink.
I don't know. Diet Pepsi Max is a warrior's drink. Actually, if anybody can drink this, this is a warrior's drink.
Let's see what my wife says.
I can't wait to find out. I can't wait to find out.
She does love the kimchi. A lot of people love that. I mean, nations eat that stuff. And they have honored recipes that have been going up and down the tree for 100 years. But
I can't even stand the smell of just cooked cabbage. It smells like dirty sweat socks. Gross.
Yeah, there's a jar she has in the fridge. And I open that up once in a while. I'm just like, that's not for me, man. That's just not for me.
Dear Lord. You poor thing, MrBubble.
Oh, it's fine.
Oh, I feel so sorry for you, though.
Oh, I'm okay.
Maybe see if the cats like this stuff. I don't know. Well, send us your comments at Yivvits and MrBubble.com. Comments at Yivvits and MrBubble.com. Yep. Comments. Can I say comments again?
Say comments one more time.
Really?
Yeah.
No, I'm not going to. Go to our podcast site, which you already know where to get it, but right. SWGpodcast.com. Twitter.
Yep. Yam. Y-A-M-B. Yep.
Y-A-M-B.
I'll post a picture of our little drink here. I took one.
It's disgusting.
Horrible one.
It's very disgusting. And if you like this flavor or any of these flavors, let me know. Let us know. You can tell us what you think.
Great.
If you have any other disgusting ones that you'd like to share.
Yeah, or suggestions for beverages.
Oh, yeah. But don't just send those to MrBubble. I don't want to.
Medical beverages.
Medical beverages.
That doesn't sound right.
Epsom salts and water.
I mean, real products.
Rubbing alcohol.
I mean, technically, you could drink anything, you know.
Yeah, what does the rubbing alcohol thing say?
Latex
paint. I think it's funny. Leaded paint.
Yeah, oh.
Anyway. And our phone number for
I don't know
voicemails.
What it is.
You do. 888-900-YAMB. 9262. We'll get our crap together here for sooner or later. We haven't got our crap together for 147 episodes.
Just a quick question.
Question?
DR Quest, Dr. Quest in the Twitter asked.
Dr. Quest.
He just asked if we had any of our old Star Wars toys from when we were young.
Yes.
What do you have? Which one?
I didn't have a lot of them, but I've got the Darth Vader carrying case.
Oh, nice.
And I have a what's the black TIE pilot guy, the one that wears all black?
Yeah. The TIE fighter pilot.
No, there's a specific one though. I'll have to show him to you because you'll know who I'm talking about. Yeah. Which one is that, Brent?
Yeah.
I just said my name.
I really
it's
Brent.
John. Oh, okay.
We're so laid back.
Let's say your address. Wait, they'll know my address.
Brent's social security number is. But
oh yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
eye color.
That's cool that you have that though.
I've got that. I have a slave one.
Do you really? From the olden days?
It's falling apart, I have one.
Though.
And there's a few other just random figures. I mean, they were like the figures that they've been in the sandbox and, you know, the cat's litter box and everything. So my kitten did actually play with a couple of them. He got up to this shelf behind us here, which is about like 8 feet off the ground. He climbed up the wall.
Did he really?
Because there's these sound panels in our podcast studio.
Uh-huh.
And he got up there and he took some figures down and played with them. He played with Jake Sully the most, the Avatar.
But the slave one and that's from the day though, right?
Yes, the day.
Okay, cool.
But I do have boxes and boxes of ones from like, you know, years ago, just a few years ago.
The 20s. Our
20s. From the 20s, yeah.
Our 20s.
Our 20s.
Your 20s.
Like we spent our 20s together.
I mean,
what is that?
Yeah, right.
Anyway.
How
about you?
I had a box. I had the Darth Vader head of figures. I sold it on eBay for $50 and I'm so frustrated. That's so stupid.
The one I've got's really beat up.
Yeah.
There's like I don't even think there's anything in it right now.
Right. I have a lot of my cards. Like I used to collect the cards. I have a container of those.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's very neat. Yeah. I got a couple old books.
Yeah. From the day?
Old books. Yeah, yeah, me like too. A pop-up book. I've seen the one that you've got that you and your friends wrote stuff in.
Yeah, it's just I know. Like fifth grade.
People barfing a lot, throwing up, fifth grade and burping comedy. And farting.
I know, and nothing's changed.
Like, if you were here like 10 minutes ago when we were paused, that's all
it's
it
like,
was.
It's like, God, my buddy and I, that's just... That and that really hasn't changed, but like there's that scene of the Death Star blowing up in the end of that Star Wars storybook, and the comment he wrote in there is like, Darth Vader did it again. So it blew up because he farted. I mean, that's basically what I think our whole...
Well, of course it would blow it up, I guess.
Yeah, of
I
mean, course Darth it would. Vader. He'd have a force fart, man. It'd blow up the whole thing, right? Darth Vader did it again!
Is that a Star Wars Galaxies ability? Force fart.
They're working on it. After they get to 1.0 in the emo.
In the PMU. The PU.
I get it.
That's great joke, Yivvits.
All right.
All right, Mr. Bubble, it's good to see you again.
You too, sir.